Hey everybody, so today we are here discussing social anxiety. And before I start this video, let me talk to you about the five signs of social anxiety. The first sign is that you find it nearly impossible to stay alone at a cafe or a restaurant and order something and eat. The second sign is that you feel very uncomfortable when you are in a big group of people, and it's very difficult for you to initiate new conversations. The third sign is that you always feel that there is something wrong with you. You are a very boring person, and you also fear that people might not like you. The fourth sign is that eye contacts are very difficult for you, and you do not know what to do when your eyes suddenly meet somebody else's eyes. The fifth one is that you have wonderful ideas. You are brilliant when presenting your ideas with an individual or a very small group of people, or when you are practicing in front of the mirror. But when it comes to presenting in front of a big number of people, you always mess things up. Honestly, we all have some level of social anxiety, but if it gets severe, it can lead to social anxiety disorder. And this can affect our life, relationships, and even career growth. I have also seen that people who have social anxiety disorder are very prone to isolation, negative self-talk, and they even have a very low self-esteem. I'm a neuroscience coach, and I consult people on how to lead a better life with the help of my knowledge about neuroscience and life coaching. So now let's decode the reasons behind social anxiety using science. There are three major reasons behind social anxiety, and the first one can be an inherited trait. Some people are automatically more prone to social anxiety because of their genes. If parents or grandparents, somebody in the family has a history of social anxiety or anxiety disorders, then that person can automatically be more prone to social anxiety. The second reason lies on the structure of our brain. There is a part of our brain called the amygdala, and it is responsible for causing anxiety because the work of amygdala is to deal with threats and fear. So if somebody has an overactive amygdala, they can react to a situation in a more intensive way, and that can cause social anxiety. The third reason can be environment and experience. If somebody has faced a very embarrassing social situation, or if somebody has been bullied as a kid, or if they had an overprotective parent or a partner, then it can also lead to social anxiety. Now let's talk about some of the most effective techniques to deal with social anxiety. I know that there are a lot of long-term solutions like journaling, yoga, meditation, and mindfulness, but I'm not going to talk about all of that today. I'm going to give you some techniques which can be directly implemented. So the first technique is power posing. Power pose was first introduced in a 2010 research, and I got to know about it from Amy Curry, who was one of the researchers who were involved in this research. So the first power pose is like this. You keep your hands in your waist, you keep your feet spread, and you stand tall as you can. I want you to practice this along with me. Keep your hands in your waist and be as straight as you can and spread your legs. Feel like you are a superman or superwoman. If you do this, if you hold this pose for at least a couple of minutes, it is said that even if you hold this position for 30 seconds, it will make you more confident. I recommend that before going to a social situation, before facing an interview or before facing a crowd, I recommend you lock yourself into a bathroom or a washroom and then hold this position for a certain period of time. Doing this is automatically going to boost your confidence and make you prepared for a social situation. Along with this power pose, there are a couple of other power poses which you can practice based on your feasibility. I'm going to show it to you on the screen. The first one shown on the picture is star fist pose, which means you can spread your hands, your arms, and your legs and look like a star fist. Then comes the CEO pose, which you can practice by sitting in a chair, keeping your legs on the table and your hands behind your neck like this. I know that you might not be able to do this everywhere, but if it's feasible, you can even try it out. The next pose is the executive pose, which means you keep your hands behind your neck like in the previous practice, but then your legs will be crossed and not exactly on a table. Then comes a victory pose where you do not do much with your legs, but you spread your arms and feel like you have won something. All of the power poses can make a significant difference in your confidence in minutes. And I want you to try everything and let me know which one do you think was the most effective. The second technique is slow and deep breathing. You can practice it either before or during a social situation. I'm going to teach you two breathing techniques that is going to make a big difference in the way you interact with people because it is going to make you more calm. The first one is box breathing. In this technique, you breathe in for 4 seconds, hold for 4 seconds, breathe out for 4 seconds, and again, hold for 4 seconds. It is called box breathing because each cycle has 4 seconds in it. The next breathing technique that you can try right now is 4-7-8, which means you breathe in for 4 seconds, you hold for 7 seconds, and you breathe out for 8 seconds. I want you to pause this video and try these breathing techniques for yourself. I'm sure you will find more peace and calm immediately after you try a couple of cycles of these breathing techniques. The third technique that we are going to discuss in this video is starting with smaller social interactions. I know that we cannot get rid of all the social anxiety in the single day, but what we can do is we can start small. We can start by saying hello and asking about how the shopkeeper who is near our house is. Or we can start by having a short conversation with a security person who is there in our office. Or we can even have a conversation with a small bunch of people and slowly and gradually start finding opportunities to interact with people around you, start going to smaller social gatherings, and then slowly and gradually increase that circle. The fourth technique that I'm going to talk to you about in this video is body grounding. A lot of times we make our anxiety worse by thinking too much about it, overthinking, or by having a bad thought and thinking about it in a loop. We need to break this loop, and that's where body grounding comes into play. Body grounding can be done by very simple exercises like just pressing your feet against the floor and noticing how it feels. Or you can just rub your hands against each other until and unless it gets warm and just feel it. When you ground yourself back to the reality, the thought chain gets broken, and that's exactly what we need. There's another really effective body grounding technique that I'm going to teach you, and it can be used not just for anxiety, but also for anxiety attacks, panic attacks, and in situations when you are thinking too much. It's called 5-4-3-2-1. What I want you to do is I want you to see 5 things, notice 5 things that you can see around you. It can be a water bottle, it can be a flower, it can be your pillow, anything. 5 things that you can see around you. Then I want you to touch 4 things. 4 things, it can be a table, a bottle, a light, your door, anything. 4 things around you that you can touch. Now I want you to hear 3 things. Notice 3 sounds that you can hear around you. And then 2 things that you can smell. It can be a smell of a flower, it can be smell of your mobile phone, anything. And lastly, I want you to taste 1 thing. It can be water. It does not have to be anything very tasty or different. It can be just simple water. So see 5 things around you, touch 4 things around you, hear 3 different sounds around you, smell 2 things around you, and taste 1 thing. We are just trying to activate our senses. And when you do that, the process of overthinking or thinking in a chain gets broken. I know that it might not be possible everywhere in social situations, but if you feel like you are getting really overwhelmed by a social situation, if you are feeling very anxious, then you can do this. Grounding techniques are very important in mental health, and they are used a lot in anxiety management therapies and counseling sessions as well. Till now, you have learned the why and how of social anxiety. Now it's time to put those learnings into practice. Remember that your brain has the ability to change, and so do you. So remember to take action. That's all for today's video, and I hope to see you in another one.